Hello everyone, this is Marek Pavlos from NCmatic. Welcome in this week's Technical Tuesday with NXCAM, the series full of practical tips and tricks about programming toolpaths in NX. Today I prepared for you 10 answers for most common questions asked by programmers who are just starting their adventure with NXCAM. Why my models look bad when I zoom in? If you are using new installation of NX, you might notice low quality of 3D models display, especially when you zoom it in. You can temporarily fix it by using Update Display option from context menu. But when you rotate your part or zoom to some other place, you will have to use Update Display again. To force NX to update faceting resolution always when you manipulate the view, you can change faceting preferences. If you set these options like I did here, you will notice that facets of the model updates immediately after you zoom the part in or out. This setting applies only to the part which is currently open. If you want to change this behavior permanently, you need to do this in customer defaults. You should see link to more detailed descriptions in upper right corner now. Why my model is broken when I import it? Sometimes, when you import large body to your work part, or when you add a large feature like I'm doing now, you might notice that it is not displayed correctly. It seems to be broken and sometimes it is displayed like surfaces. The reason is that zoom scale is focused on small part. To adjust the center and correctly scale work view of your new large part, you need to use fit option. It can be done using context menu, icon available in the menu, or simply with Ctrl F shortcut. How can I reuse my CAM operations from my previous projects? Here you have example of two CAM operations, roughing and rest milling. Let's assume that it took me some time to adjust all settings, options, and cutting parameters for these operations. I would like to avoid doing it from the beginning in my next CAM project. With NX, I can simply copy these operations, switch to my new project, which doesn't contain any operations or tools, and paste operations here. Notice that operations were copied together with tools. All I need to do is to regenerate toolpaths. Copying operations is the most basic approach. If you would like more advanced way, see the video which I'm linking now. My CAM project uses metric units. How can I provide some dimensions in inches? It is very simple, but not many users are aware about it. In NX dialogs, where you usually provide digits only, you can also do some calculations. For example, here I will type 0.5 inch, hit Tab key, and the NX automatically converted my input to metric. Let me know in the comments if you were aware about this feature. You can do even more math in this field. Let's try adding, multiplying, power or square root. How can I machine multiple not connected regions in an XCAM turning in single operation? This is a very common question. By default, turning operations in an X will create toolpaths only for first region, which it will find. To machine multiple regions in single operation, all you need to do is to change region machining option to multiple in cut regions. I can't see NX dialog windows. In some situations, if you use your computer with different external monitors, and someday you will disconnect these monitors, you might be in a situation where you can't see dialog windows. It is because they are displayed out of your screen boundaries. It is very simple to fix. You can use reset window position command in NX user interface preferences. Why my tools preview is displayed in some weird position? As you can see here, you might experience situations where tool is displayed in some unexpected position. To understand why, you need to know that there are more coordinate systems than just MCS, machine coordinate system. One of them is work coordinate system, WCS. You can position this coordinate system whenever you like using orient WCS command. How can I change one option in multiple operations at the same time? In NX, you can set feeds and speeds of CAM operations by selecting multiple operations and choosing feed rates option. Another parameter which can be modified for multiple operations is stock value, which is stored in methods. But as you can see, that's basically all. If you would like to be able to set all other parameters for multiple operations, you can use bulk edit application, which is part of NCmatic toolkit for NX. Here you can see how bulk edit can be used, for example, to turn on cutter compensation for all these Z-level operations. How can I select object which is overlapped by another object? As you can see here, I'm trying to select part geometry, but when I click it, blank geometry is being selected because it is bigger and it overlaps the part. In situations like this, it is helpful to use Quick Pick tool. To be able to precisely select some object, move your mouse over the object and hold it still until you will see three small dots next to your cursor. Then click with left mouse button and small dialog of Quick Pick will be displayed. In this window, you can easily select which object you intended to select. How can I simply generate CAM project summary for machine operator? The simplest way, which not many users is aware about, is exporting entire operation navigator tree and just print it. You will find this option in context menu. You can even reorganize columns, which are displayed in the navigator. You can remove or add some of them, and you can manipulate order of columns. This way, on the printed summary, you will see only the details you need. If exported operation navigator tree is not enough, you can try to generate shop documentation or use work instruction authoring tool. And to get setup sheets, tool lists and operation lists full of details useful when setting up the machine and tools, you should try NC Reports. You will find more information about NC Reports at my website. All the best and see you in next Technical Tuesday with the next NCmatic.